We are starting a very important subject on today. I spoke about it in course of the teaching last week. I'm going to be talking about a very important subject on this week. I am starting that series today. I am starting it today. For the past 3 weeks, we have been really digging into a lot of things, I believe, that has brought us to the place of revelation about our personal challenges, about the issues of our lives, about how to obtain substantial testimony and also deliverance for our lives. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. And on today, I am going to start a very good series from the book of Matthew chapter 13. If you can just please get your Bible, get your notes, get your pen. We are going to the book of Matthew chapter number 13. And I'm starting a very, very important subject from the book of Matthew chapter number 13. Glory be to the name of the Father. I hope everyone is saved. I believe you are renewing our altar. Yes, that's one of the messages we preach about. We talk about renewing our altar. We spoke about the evil dedication. We spoke about destroying demonic covenant. We talk about the power of sacrifice. On last week, we spoke about the power of sacrifice, and we talk about obedience. We talk about the outpouring of His Spirit as the Spirit of the Lord came upon the life of Azariah, and in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 15 that we were talking about. Glory to God. And by the grace of God, I hope so far everyone is fine. I hope everyone is doing good. Everyone is being safe. You are staying safe. You are using your you are using your mask. You are using your hand sanitizer, washing of your hands, as we are all taking the precaution of what is being given to us in the physical. We'll still continue praying in the spiritual. It is the spiritual that governs what happens in the physical realm. It is the spiritual that governs what transpired, what goes on in the physical realm. Hallelujah. So I believe that everyone is staying safe at home. Everyone is being doing good. We talk about forgiveness on Sunday. Yes, we talk about the forgiveness on Sunday. And I received messages and testimony how people now see the forgiveness is a weapon that we can use over the devil, or the enemy can use to gain advantage over us. So we have to live a life of absolute forgiveness. I'm telling you, try your conscious effort to forgive one another. Hallelujah. There are prayers that cannot be answered if we live in forgiveness. There are some realms we cannot go with God if we are still abhorring and living in unforgiveness. Unforgiveness is cancerous. It's like a cancer that eats up destiny. So I pray that God will still giving you and empowering you with grace. It's a process. Don't condemn yourself. It's a process. Deliverance is progressive. It's a process. And as you have made a conscious effort to live a life of forgiveness, forgive those that have hurt you. I received many messages on that subject of forgiveness. And I pray by the grace of God that the Lord will give you the ability and the grace to forgive. Ability and the grace to forgive, so that you can live a life that is pleasing to God and required of our Maker. Glory to God. Let's go today to the book of Matthew chapter number 13. Someone should help me project it on the scripture. Matthew chapter 13. Matthew chapter number 13. I welcome all the men of God, all the women of God on this broadcast. I thank you for taking your time to be part of this broadcast. And I can tell you, is going to be a great blessing to your life and family. Hallelujah. Go with me to the book of Matthew chapter number 13. Before we read the scripture, please let me establish this. We live in a season of fear and anxiety. We live in a season where everyone has been talking about fear. Everyone has been talking about how fearful our world has become. But in the place of fear and perplexity, it is God's word that you need the most to overcome the fear of the world. The world will always bring a fearful scenario, but when you are a child of God, you build up your most holy faith in studying the Bible. You build up your most holy faith in prayer. And you build up your most holy faith just in believing in your God. Glory to God. Nothing will touch you. No force, no power, no attack of the devil will overtake you or exert on your family. Glory be to God. In this critical moment we're living in, I believe that we need God's word like never before. We need the word of God like never before. And I will advise also, even in the midst of this shutdown, take it as an opportunity to discover something about your life. Take it as an opportunity to enhance your walk with God and to also discover something about your life. Sit down and take yourself through self-discovery. Don't maximize the time. There is shutdown out there, but there should not be shutdown in your spirit. There is shutdown out there, but there should not be any shutdown with your connectivity with your Maker. Glory be to God. So I am starting a very, very important deliverance series today. Deliverance series that is going to be a blessing to your life. It's going to be an eye-opener to that which the devil is doing in your life. Glory be to the name of the Father. Yes, the man of God said, we need the word of God never before, like never before. You need the word of God like never before. The Bible said the word of God is able to sanctify you and to give you inheritance among those that are sanctified. The word of God is able to keep you and to sanctify you and to give you inheritance among those that are sanctified. So you see that the word of God It has the ability to purify. It has the ability to sanctify. It has the ability to build you up. It has the ability to give you inheritance. And watch this. Anything you desire of God is what you have. The answers to what you desire of God is what you have not discovered in His word. Anything you desire of God, the solution is in the word of is in His word. So when you have time in sitting down with the word of God, you are going through barrenness. Solution is in the word of God. There is no solution in the world we live in. Solution is in the word of God. If there is any solution to what we are dealing with, by now we could have gotten the solution. So this situation is an eye-opener for us to know that all these helter-skelters of life, no solution of what you are dealing with is in the world. It's in the word of God, not in the world. Whatever the word of God cannot handle, the world has no solution. Glory to God. So let us go to the book of Matthew. Holy Spirit, somebody help us to just project the scripture. Matthew chapter 13. I am starting a very good, interesting topic today. Very exciting, very eye-opener topic. The Bible says from verse 24. Help me project it. Matthew chapter 13, verse number 24. We are reading some couple of verses today, and it's a very familiar scripture. But by the grace of God, every man of God is given the revelation, understanding of the scripture by his assignment and the people he has been sent to. I believe you are watching me today because I have been sent to speak to you. I believe we are connecting together in the spirit right now because I have been sent to you for such a time as this. You have been sent my way for such a time as this. Glory be to God. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 13, we are reading from verse 24 to 28, and we will jump to verse 37 to 38. Matthew 13, verse 24. Another parable put he forth unto them. This was Jesus speaking. Please listen to this message. It's going to bless your life. We are going to pray prayers of deliverance. We are going to pray for our nations, and we are going to pray for families. The Bible says in verse 24, another parable Jesus put forth to his disciple, saying, the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven, is likened unto a man which sowed good seed in his field. I am speaking today on the mystery of the seed and the sower. The mystery of the seed and the sower. The mystery of the seed and the sower. I'm speaking on it on today, and I'll establish it today. We will build on it for the week. And as we pray a deliverance prayer, I'm going to lead you through a deliverance declaration. I'm going to lead you to deliverance out prayer. The Bible says the kingdom of God is likened unto a man which soweth good seed in his field. Verse 25. But while men slept, his enemies, the enemies of the sower, his enemy came and sowed thirst among the weeds and went his way. Please follow this message carefully. Yes, thank you. Click like, click love, and make a comment. But while the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tears also. When the blade, the seed began to grow, then appeared tears also. Verse 27. So when the servant of the householder came and said unto the master, say, did not thou sow good seed in thy field? From whence then at thirst cometh? Verse 28. He said unto them, An enemy has done this. I don't know what the enemy has done in your life. I don't know what the enemy has done against your destiny. I don't know what the enemy is doing in your life and family, against your children, against your destiny. I came in the name of Jesus. I come in the volumes of the books. I come by the force of the blood of Jesus. Every work of the devil, every aggression of the enemy in your life, anything the devil has done against your destiny, in the name of Jesus, it shall be destroyed by the power of the Holy Ghost. It shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Come on, church, give me some feedback. Amen. Let me know you are hearing the sound of my voice. Hallelujah. Verse number 28, he said unto them, an enemy has done this. The servant said unto him, without then that we go and gather them up. That was verse 28. Let's go to verse 37. Let's go straight to verse 37 of the same scripture. the verse 27 of Matthew chapter 13. And hear this message. It's going to open your eyes. And he said unto them, Jesus said unto them, he that soweth the good seed is the Son of Man. He that soweth the good seed. Put a mark on that. I am coming. He that soweth the good seed is the Son of Man. Verse 38, the last verse. The field is the world. The field is the world we live in. The good seed are the children of the kingdom. The good seed are the children of the kingdom. But the tares are the children of the wicked one. Oh my goodness. The tares are the children of the wicked one. Number one, we see a story of a farmer went to his field and planted a seed. Went to the field and planted a good seed. And when men slept, you know, we have heard a lot of messages that the word men slept could be related, which I believe, to when men refused to pray. But this man has labored all through the day. This man has been in the farm planting good seed and was tired. He went home to take a nap, to rest and revive his energy to go back to the field. And the Bible said, suddenly an enemy also went at the vulnerable time of this man's life. An enemy went behind the man and planted to attack the good seed. Number one, understand clearly that you are a good seed in the hands of the Lord. Hear this message. It's going to bless your life. You are a good seed in the hands of the Lord. Verse 38 said that good seed are the children of the kingdom. So you understand that you are a good seed. God planted in the womb of your mother before you were given birth to on the earth. I'm going to break it down. You are a good seed. Let us evaluate seed now before I proceed. Let us evaluate this word called seed. S-E-E-D. Let us evaluate it. You understand, when we're talking about a seed, inside a seed are many potential. So if the Bible said in verse 38 that you are the good seed that was planted on this earth, that tells me inside you are great potentials. I'm coming to what happens to you now, because many of you will be like, if I'm a good seed, why am I going through all this? The Bible said, an enemy has done it. And as we proceed in this message, I am going to be showing it to us, the area the enemy has entered, the area at which give the enemy advantage to attack your productivity as a seed. Every seed has potentials. Every seed has ability. Every seed has capacity. Understand before I proceed. Every seed has the capacity to reproduce. Every seed has the ability to be fruitful. Every seed has the capacity called talent. Glory to God. I'm feeling some fire already in my bone. Every seed, so let us evaluate seed very carefully, because if you don't know what a seed carried, you might not understand this scripture. Inside a tiny seed lies a great potential. Potential for fruitfulness is in a small seed. Capacity to multiply is in a small seed. It doesn't matter how little the seed is. Every seed has the ability to become a tree. Every seed in the future, as it grows, has the potential to be stable and bring forth many fruits. So the Bible said, you are a seed in the hands of the Lord. A farmer sowed a good seed. You are a good seed. Settle it. There are potentials lying in your system. I am going to tell you what has happened to those potentials. As a seed, you have the ability to be fruitful. Holy Spirit, as a seed, you have the capacity that is being enveloped with potentials. So while you are watching me right now, there are great potential lying inside of you. There are ability that is lying dormant inside of you. It doesn't matter the size of any seed. That small seed has the ability to produce and be fruitful. Holy Spirit. You are a great seed in the hands of the Lord. You are a good seed, because many are asking questions about their destiny. Many are asking questions, why my life is like this? In the course of this deliverance teaching, do you understand what transpired in your life? Why we are building this case, the mystery of the seed and the sower. The Bible may declare that the sower of the seed is the Son of Man, is God. The sower of the seed is God. You existed in God before you were born on earth. Holy Spirit, help me today. You existed. The seed was in the hands of the sower. And the sower is God. And anything in the hands of God is called beautiful. So if you are a seed in the hands of God, and you are planted on earth, it tells me why you are being planted on earth. There are potentials in you that must be seen by your word. Holy Spirit of God. There are light potential. There are innate ability for you to reproduce. So when you are going through unproductivity, something is wrong. According to the intention of the sower, according to the expectation of the sower, he sowed a good seed and expecting to receive a reward of fruitfulness. Holy Spirit of God, thank you, Father. So you are a good seed in the hands of God. You are planted with potential on this earth. There are potentials in you. You carry an inbuilt capacity to be multiplied, to be fruitful on this planet earth. Inside every seed is a tree. Inside every tree is ability. Inside every tree is potential to be fruitful. Because the seed is planted on the soil to bring about many more fruits. Holy Spirit. So Bible says in verse 38 that the sower is God. The vineyard is the word which you are planted to. And the seed is you, the people, the children of the kingdom. So, when you look at yourself, you are a child of the kingdom. You are a seed planted, and God has an expectation for you to be fruitful. Every seed sower, every farmer planted the seed with expectation to reap. Oh my God, God help me today. God help me today. Hallelujah. So while you are watching me right now, it doesn't matter what you are going through. Don't give up on yourself. Inside of you is greatness and capacity. Inside of you as a seed is ability and potentials. But when the devil, the Bible said, when the man slept, the enemy came and attacked the seed. Let me tell you, there are many seeds in the farm. There are many farms in the neighborhood. But there was a particular seed the enemy attacked and they planted evil. Let me tell you, this is where the problem lies. The Bible declares and said in verse 26, when the blade was springing up, when the seed started growing, this is the problem of many of us now. When the seed planted started growing, then suddenly there was an appearance of tears. From the planting of the seed, the devil as the enemy attacked the seed, but nobody knew about it. When the seed grew and started growing in life, the seed grew to a state of prosperity. Now they realize something is wrong with the seed. Nothing happened to the seed when the seed was planted, but they began to see other negative occurrences as it relates to the growth of the seed. You are a seed, not just a seed, a good seed in the hands of the Lord. When you are being planted in your mother's womb, God has an expectation of greatness about you. When the day you were born on this earth, God has an expectation of productivity and fruitfulness of you. But while you started growing up, the battles of life began to bring out what the devil has done in your life. Oh my Jesus. Are you hearing me? Please give me some feedback, please. I want you to catch this message. A farmer said, when the seed began to grow, then appear suddenly from nowhere. This is what we call a sudden attack on your destiny. Many of you, when you were growing up, very brilliant, very talented, but in the journey of life, suddenly you realize things are not working. Suddenly you realize something is going wrong because the seed, thank you, Father. The seed was not attacked not to grow up, but the seed was attacked not to bring forth fruit. The enemy attacked the potential of the seed. The enemy went after the capacity of the seed. So when the seed started growing, then they realized something went wrong. Watch this. It was the day the seed was planted that the enemy attacked the seed. That is where you see many of you started your battle from your mother's womb. The day your mother discovered you being planted in a womb, battle began. The seed was attacked the day the sower planted the seed. But nobody realized the attack was not to hinder the growth of the seed. The attack was to hinder the fruitfulness of the seed. Holy Spirit. The attack of the enemy against you is not to kill you. They cannot kill you because of the original assignment of God and the covering of the blood upon your life. But what the devil is attacking in your life is for you not to be fruitful. The attack of the devil is to see your destiny not multiplying. So when you look at this scripture, the Bible said, the same night when the seed was planted and the sower went to sleep, the enemy planted and attacked the destiny of that seed. That seed still grew up. That seed still germinated. That seed, as the point of giving birth and become to bring harvest, then they realize sudden attack over the seed, sudden appearance of the works of the devil. And let's hear what the Bible said in verse 28. The servant went to the master. Didn't we sow a good seed? Many of you are asking the same question. Am I not created by God? Is it not God that created me? Where are all the prophecies I have received? The servant was asking the master, like you have been asking God a question, and hear the response of God. Hear the response of the master. Mind you, the sower of that seed was God. You are the seed, the children of the kingdom. The field is the world we live in, called the planet Earth. The servant asked a question. Didn't we sow a good seed? Is it not a good destiny you have for my life? Didn't you say in your word, be fruitful and multiply? Many of you are asking questions. Hear the answer in verse 28. He said unto them, an enemy has done this. An enemy has done this. This one is the work of the enemy. I planted you on the planet Earth as a good seed in your mother's womb. A seed with great potential. A seed with great ability. A seed with great capacity. But when the seed started growing, the first year, 2 years, 10 years old, 15 years old, at the peak of you getting to maturity of destiny, you began to see demonic occurrences in your life, which you cannot actually answer to those questions of life. But Jesus said, an enemy has done this. There is an attack from the pit of hell against the seed. The attack is not to kill the seed. The attack is to hinder the productivity of the seed. I pray for you today. Every attack of the enemy, every attack of wickedness against your productivity, against your capacity, against every potential God has embedded in your life, every aggression of the devil, every finger of wickedness against you, I speak in the name of Jesus. I command you to catch fire right now. I command you to catch fire right now. I command every power of wickedness, fighting every potential, ability to be fruitful in your life and destiny. Let it be arrested by the blood of Jesus. Let it be arrested by the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father. If you are hearing me, please give me some feedback. Give me some feedback. Give me some feedback. Glory be to the name of the Father. Give me some feedback. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. You are a good seed, but the devil is attacking your fruitfulness. You are a seed with potential, but the enemy is fighting your productivity. You are a seed with great prophetic destiny, but the devil is fighting your ability to be fruitful. But today, in the name of Jesus, every work of the enemy, every work of wickedness fighting your fruitfulness, fighting your capacity, fighting your potential, fighting your dream, every aggression of the enemy, every finger of wickedness against your life and destiny, in the name of Jesus Christ, I declare by the word of the Lord, by the fire of the Holy Ghost, let that agenda cast fire, let that aggression by fire, let that aggression cast fire. Every wicked attack, every wicked plot, every wicked agenda against your productivity, against your stability, against your destiny, in the land of the living, by the word of the Lord, by the force of the blood and the power of the Holy Ghost, I speak your deliverance from every work of wickedness. I break you out. I command the work of the devil come to an end by fire. Come to an end by fire. In the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody shout yes. Come on, shout yes. Come on, shout yes. Alama soda malaga da gada gada gada. Rekubu shande bregedia. This is the story of many people. They have great potential, but no productivity. They have great ability, well talented, but there is no result to show for it. Because an enemy somewhere, somehow. Watch this. My issue is, where were the enemy? Holy Spirit. When you look at that scripture, in verse 28, Jesus said unto them, an enemy has done this. Can I tell you, to the greatness of your destiny, you have an enemy. Because when the sower was planting the seeds, how did the enemy know where the seed was planted? Monitoring spirits. How did the enemy know that the sower is asleep? Monitoring spirits. That tells me two things. Among the people that were there when the farmer was planting the seed was an informant. You got to check people around you. There are people that will never fight you until a new discovery of greatness begins to manifest in your life. Another thing I believe is, how did the enemy know where the seed was planted? There were many seeds that were planted. But there was a particular seed the enemy attacked. That tells me enemy must have been monitoring the man. Enemy must have been close to the man to know when the man was sleeping, to know when the man planted the seed. You have to watch your company. Who is monitoring every potential in you? Who is monitoring your manifestation and destiny? There are battles of your life that shows forth when you are about to enter some destiny in life. When you are about to fly to the higher height of destiny, that is when some enemy begin to show forth. An enemy has done it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who told the enemy where the seed was planted? In your family, somebody with an evil eye saw you in the womb of your mother as a good seed and attack your destiny. Well, that is why many of you went through battles from your mother's womb, because the enemy saw and sensed greatness when your mother carried you in a womb. Many of you, your mother nearly miscarried your destiny because of the battle she went through while you were in the womb. Why? Because the devil with an evil eye saw a greatness was in your mother's womb. When your firstborn was, when the firstborn of your mother was conceived, no battle. When the second born was conceived, no battle. Why, when you were conceived, your mother went through battles of life when you were in the womb? Because the enemy could sense a destiny. There is somebody, I don't know, and the Holy Ghost is actually communicating to somebody right now. The Lord is speaking to somebody. That when you went, you went through battles in your mother's womb. Your mother nearly miscarried you. Your mother nearly lost you while you were in the womb. There were battles upon battles. Your mama nearly miscarried you in the womb. And yet you are growing up. You are fighting battles upon battles. It's because of that destiny the Lord placed on you as a seed. It's because of that potential you carry as a good seed. It's because of the destiny God has placed upon you as a good seed. But can I tell you a good news? Even though the enemy fought the seed, even though the devil fought the seed, they could not stop the growth. They could not stop the harvest of the seed. I don't care how the devil has fought you. I don't care what the devil has done against your life. I don't care the attacks of the enemy, the arrows of wickedness thrown against your destiny. I have a word for you today. I have a good news for that woman today. You will maximize that potential. You will fulfill that destiny. That seed will not die within you. That potential will not die. That capacity will not die. That dream will not die. Come on, give me some fire shout and say yes. Thank you, Father. You are a good seed in the hands of the Lord. You have been planted on this earth by God with capacity to expand, ability to be fruitful. Why you are not seeing the fruitfulness is because of the wickedness of men. Why you are not seeing the productivity is because of the wickedness of the wicked. But I prophesy now, I prophesy now, I prophesy over that woman, over that lady, over that mama, that papa. I speak in the name of Jesus, every attack of wickedness over your destiny, every attack of wickedness from your mother's womb, every attack of wickedness from your family line, every attack of wickedness from any uncle, every attack of wickedness from any auntie, every attack of the devil against your potentials and capacity, in the name of resurrected Christ, by the power of the Holy Ghost, I command that attack to cast fire now. I prophesy your deliverance. I prophesy your miracles. I prophesy your fruitfulness. I prophesy your lifting. I prophesy it now. I prophesy it now. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you are serving a living God. You are serving a mighty God. You are serving a powerful God. If that God bless you, no power can curse you. If that God lift you up, no power can bring you down. I see power coming to you. I see fire coming to you. I see devil flee out of your life. I see curses being broken now. In the name of Jesus, come and shout yes. My. I am a good seed. Come on, type it. I am a good seed in the hand of God. I am a good seed. I am a good seed. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. You are a good seed. You are more than a conqueror. You are a good seed. Good words God have started, and He will finish it upon your life. You are a good seed, and faithful is He that have called you, for He also shall fulfill it. You are a good seed. Therefore, even though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you shall fear no evil, for God is with you. I am a good seed. Come on, type it. I am a good seed. Nothing can kill my dream. Nothing can choke my potential. I shall be fruitful in the land of the living. I am a good seed. Come on, type it, type it, type it. I am a good seed. My goodness, you are a good seed. The devil attacked the seed, but God intervened for the seed, because the planter of the seed is greater than the enemy of the seed. The Bible said, the one that soweth that seed is the Son of God. The one that soweth that seed is God Himself. And you, the children of the kingdom, you are the seed that God has planted on this earth to prosper. You have been planted on this earth to be fruitful. You have been planted on this earth to be multiplied. You have been planted on this earth to get married and be happy. You have been planted on this earth to prosper in whatever you lay your hands upon. And the Bible said, the tears, the one that sowed the tears, is the son and the children of the devil. I prophesy over your life, over your family. Receive the voice of deliverance now. Receive fire for deliverance now. Deliverance from the hands of the enemy. Deliverance from the hands of the devil. You will maximize that dream. You will fulfill that dream. That dream will not die. You will fulfill that potential. I call for greatness in you. I call for multiplicity in you. I call for fruitfulness in you. I call for greatness in you. I call for favor in you. I call it forth. I call it forth. I call it forth. I call it forth. Oh, la mama, 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 mama. Rekotoba shagabaya. The Bible said, even though the enemy attacked the seed, God came through for the seed, because God was the sower of that seed. In other words, you are a seed God has planted on this earth. I know you are going through battles of failure. This seed went through battles of failure. I know you are going through battles of disappointment. This seed went through battles of disappointment. I know you are going through the battles of unproductivity. This seed was attacked not to be productive, but at the end of the day, the one that planted the seed came to the rescue of the seed. The one that planted the seed delivered the seed from the hands of the enemy. I prophesy, because you are planted on this earth by God Jehovah, by Helelion, by Jehovah Tibera, by Jehovah Kwana, by Jehovah Tseboat, any aggression against your life, any finger of wickedness against your productivity, I command, God shall deliver you by fire. My God will deliver you. My Father will deliver you. Come on, shout, yes, I am delivered. Oh, my. Thank you, my God. Thank you, my Father. You are a good seed. Settle it in your mind. Don't let any devil misinterpret your destiny for you because of the challenges of your life. This seed went through challenges, went through the attacks of the devil. but could not stop the seed from manifesting its potential, from manifesting its capacity, from manifesting its greatness. Don't let what the devil is doing be the definition of God's original agenda for your life. Say to it, I am a good seed. It doesn't matter where you have been squeezed, you will break forth at the end of the day. It doesn't matter where you have been pressed down. Sometimes in life, you must go through the season of pressed down, season of shaking together, before you can enter the man and the season of running over. You are going through season of pressed down now. You are going through season of shaking together now. Therefore, I see your running over miracle. I see your running over testimony. I see it coming in the name of resurrected Christ. Come on, receive it now. Come on, receive it now. My goodness. My God, the Lord is speaking to somebody. You feel like giving up. I came to tell you, don't give up. You feel like giving up. Don't give up on your destiny. Don't give up on your destiny. Because I see God coming to deliver you. I see God coming for you. I see God coming for your destiny. I see God coming for you. As God came through for this seed, and this seed cannot be stopped. It doesn't matter your challenges. Don't be discouraged. God is coming for you. God is coming for you. The Bible said the other day, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they were good seed that God deployed on an assignment. Shadrach was a good seed. Meshach was a good seed. Abednego was a good seed on an assignment for divinity. And men put them in the fire. But the Bible said, inside the fire, fourth man appeared. Fourth man did not appear in the palace. Fourth man did not appear when they were taking them to the fire. While they were yet in the fire, that was where fourth man appeared. In that situation, God shall appear to deliver you. In that disappointment, in that betrayal, in that failures of life, my God shall appear to deliver you. He may not appear to deliver you last year. It might seem like all hope is gone. Until you get through the fire, God might not appear. Until you have been accused, God might not appear. I pray for that woman. I pray for that family. Going through the battles of life, you have been choked on every side. Financially choked, maritally choked, emotionally choked. Your earth is being choked. I speak in the name of Jesus. The same God that came through for this seed, the same God that intervened for Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, that God shall intervene and deliver you. That God shall intervene and deliver you. I prophesy in the name of resurrected Christ. Receive deliverance now. Receive deliverance now. Receive deliverance now. Ah, my goodness. My. Holy Spirit of God, you are a good seed. There are great potential lying down in you. There are giftings you have not tapped into. The situations of life has limited your potential. The challenges of life has incapacitated your capacity. The battles of your family line is contending with your destiny for lifting. But God came through for this seed. We are going to lift up prayer. We are going to lift up prayer. That is a wicked attack against your destiny. Don't give up. Just deal with the devil. When you look at this scripture, the sower did not give up on the seed. Holy Spirit. Look at that scripture. The sower, who knew the capacity of that seed, the potential lied in that seed, did not give up on that seed. Don't let the devil think the Lord has given up on you.
Don't let the devil make you believe that God has given up on you. It doesn't matter the fierceness of your battle. God will never give up on his own. It doesn't matter what you are dealing with, the failures, the disappointment of life, God will never give up on his own. Please settle it in your mind. Bible said, I was young, now I am old. I never seen a righteous, a child of God being forsaken. God does not forsake his own. Men might abandon you, but God will not abandon his own. Men might reject you, God will not reject his own. Men might ridicule you, God will not ridicule his own. The enemy attacked the seed. We are going to pray from this scripture. Many of you, your battle started from your mother's womb. From the day the seed was planted, the enemy threw an attack. The enemy attacked the seed from the day the seed was planted. The day you were planted in your mother's womb, what this? The enemy could not attack the seed in the hands of the sower. In the hands of the sower. But when the seed was planted, the enemy attacked. That is what we call time-sensitive attack on destiny. We are going to pray about that. The day the seed was planted and the sower went to rest, the enemy attacked the seed. But this is wickedness. The sower has been working and laboring and laboring. Many of you have struggled and fought in life. The day you decided to take a break and relax, the devil attacked your destiny. The devil did not attack the seeds not to grow. The enemy said, "We shall allow the seed to grow, but we will not allow the seed to be fruitful and multiply." And your agenda on earth, behind the mind of every farmer, is to see the seed fruitful. That is why in Genesis chapter 1 verse 27, when God planted Adam as a seed, he pronounced his expectation about Adam: be fruitful. That was the expectation of God about you. Be multiplied. That was the expectation of God for Adam as a seed. The moment the devil heard God's expectation, the devil said, "We cannot kill Adam, but we will take productivity out of man." Holy Spirit, your battle started from your mother's womb. Many of you, I am talking to you prophetically. Holy Ghost is unveiling your case, opening up the book of your life. You started battles from your mother's womb. Can I tell you, any child of yours, you are going through battles. Holy Spirit, thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Yes, Lord. Hear this. I just hear this in my spirit. There is somebody under the sound of my voice before we pray. There is one of your child. There is one of your child. One of your child. One of your child. One of your child. You went through battles over that child. There are battles about that child that started from the womb. A particular child of yours, out of the children, particular, you went through battles from the womb over that child. I am hearing in my spirit to tell you that child is a great child. The devil sensed greatness, and the devil came after to abort that child, but the child escaped. And from the day that child was born, it has been one battle to another battle over that child. I don't know who I am talking to. I don't know who the Holy Ghost is speaking to. The child from the womb should have been aborted. The child could have been miscarried. But you were able to bring forth that child. And from the day the child was born, it has been one battle to another battle over that child. But I have a good news for you. That child and not that child. Speak over that child. The enemy has sensed greatness about that child. That child is a great child. Are you, oh my labo, shada baragada gada gada. If you don't carry greatness, devil will not come after you. When you look at the scripture that we read, there were many seed in the field. But the devil did not attack all the seeds. The enemy went after one particular seed. An enemy has done it. Let me tell you, if you carry greatness, it will attract an enemy. If you carry potential, you will attract an enemy. You will be criticized. You might be ostracized. People will ridicule you because of the greatness you carry within you. Hallelujah. The day Moses was conceived and the enemy sensed that a deliverer was born, he pronounced a demonic decree to start killing the male born of Hebrew women. There was no massacre or killing of destiny until Moses, that was a seed God planted to deliver his people, was born. Hallelujah. Until Jesus was conceived as a seed to redeem humanity, Herod did not issue demonic decree. The enemy sends the greatness lieth in you as a seed. Every seed is expected to be fruitful. Every seed is expected to multiply. Every seed has an inbuilt capacity to grow and bear fruits without struggle. So you are going through a lot of struggle before you produce. An enemy has done it. You are a good seed, but you are not fruitful in life. Nothing is coming forth. Even though you are serving God, the Bible said, an enemy has done it. An enemy has done it. You are serving God. You are trusting God. Marriage is not coming forth. You are a wife material. You carry the capacity to build a good home. But no marriage coming forth. Going through cycles of disappointment. You are in a place now where you don't even try to trust in this thing called marriage anymore. An enemy has done this. From the beginning, Bible said it was not so. My goodness. Give me a feedback, please. Karabo Shanda Bragadia. Rekutu Bragadia. You are in a place where you have tried and toiled and struggled. And the more you struggle, the more it seems nothing is coming forth. You are still a good seed. It's only because you have not dealt with the work of the devil against your productivity. Jesus said, hear what Jesus said. Didn't you plant a good seed? Jesus did not deny the fact that he planted a good seed. Jesus said, an enemy has done it. You have an enemy. You don't know. This enemy that did it was on hiding. Maybe, Holy Spirit, maybe the enemy that attacked the potential, the productivity of this seed was even there when the farmer was planting the seed. Maybe this enemy was a friend to the sower of the seed. Who is your friend? Many of you, where you are now, was because of what your own best friend did to you. You don't have a best friend. Jesus should be your best friend. You only have a companion. Nobody can be your best friend. Only Jesus is your best friend. You only have a companion. Because where you are now, if you have not met that person you call your best friend, you could have gone further than this. The one you call your best friend is the genesis of what you are going through. David said the other day, this is not an enemy that has done this to me. This is my own friend. This is my companion. This is my best friend. We go to the house of God together. Some of those your enemies also go to church. David said, we pray together. Who is your prayer partners? Some of your enemies are people you are praying with. They pray with you so that they can know your problem to mock you. In the place of prayer, you share your prayer point with them and they take it as a weapon to fight you. Who is your prayer partners? David said, we go to the house of God together. We pray together. We take counsel together. Who is your counselor? Who is advising you? Who do you share your problem with? You have to be really careful. Some people you share your problem with, they are the ones selling you to your enemies. I believe, possibly, the enemy that attacked this good seed was there when they were planting the seeds. When you were conceived in your mother's womb, who was the friend to your mother that attacked you in the womb? The day of your child baby shower, who were the people that attended? Are they your enemies or are they your friends? The enemy that attacked the seed, I am sure, had a substantial information about the farm, about the seed, about the farmer. He must be close to that farmer. He must be close to the seed sower to know when the man was sleeping. Knows when the man goes out. The enemy fighting you knows everything about you. The most enemy that can fight you very easily, they know the time you go to bed, they know the time you go to work, they have your schedule at the palm of their hands. So they know when to attack you, they know your strength, they know your weakness. Be careful. Be careful. We live one of the attack of the end time is for friend to betray friends. Is for father to betray children. Is for children to betray father. Is for nations to betray nations. Is part of the agenda of the end time. Be careful. Jesus said, be wise as a serpent. As a serpent. Not every dream you share with everybody. This farmer must have told his enemy when he was going to the farm. This farmer, this sower, must have told the enemy that attacked the seed. Even when he finished planting, I just finished planting a very good seed. I am going home to take some nap. And the enemy said, we shall see. While he was sleeping, his enemy, you have an enemy, you don't know. Today, every hidden enemy in your life, I am praying for a woman right now. Every hidden enemy in your life, in your camp, every enemy living with you in your house, any enemy within your family, by the hand of the Lord, let them be exposed by fire. Let them be exposed by fire. Every unfriendly friends, every enemy at your workplace, every enemy in your neighborhood, every enemy in your apartments, every enemy among your friends, let them be exposed by fire. Every enemy in your church, every enemy in your congregation, let them be exposed by fire. Let them be exposed by fire. Let them be exposed by fire.
My God,
the sower sowed a good seed. While he was sleeping, his enemies.
Verse 25.
His enemies. You have an enemy. There is an enemy
that have called himself your friend.
There is an enemy
you share your secret with and using it against you, behind you.
There is an enemy you are confiding in, yet is using it to torment you. There is an enemy. What would say? His enemy. May God expose every enemy in your life. May God expose unfriendly friends in your life. May God expose the enemy in your family. That demonic auntie, that satanic uncle, that demonic sister, that witchcraft friend in your life, may fire expose them. May thunder expose them. May fire expose the enemy. May thunder expose the enemy. Come on, shout expose, expose, expose. Shout it. Shout it, shout it. Let them be exposed. Let them be exposed. Let them be exposed. Let them be exposed. An enemy told your helper something. An enemy told your helper something. An enemy destroyed you to your partner. An enemy destroyed you to your husband. Your own best friend. Your own best friend is the one that sabotage you in your, it will sabotage you to your own partners. Your own friend is part of the problem. Why you lost that job? Why you lost that job? Unfriendly friends, let them be exposed. The Bible said, the sower sowed a good seed. A good seed. His enemies attacked the seed. I said, this seed will not be fruitful. This seed will not multiply. Somebody envied your mother when you were conceived. Somebody said something against you while you were yet in your mother's womb. Somebody monitored your destiny and saw potentials, saw giftings and talents, capacity to be productive, and attack it and left you vulnerable. Left you vulnerable and empty. Left you to struggle in life. Left you to struggle in destiny. But may fire expose them now. The work of wickedness against your destiny, let fire destroy it now. Let fire destroy it now. My God. An enemy has done this. Believe me, from tomorrow, I'll begin to expose some enemies. that is behind your ability to be fruitful. Jesus said, an enemy has done this. And I don't know which one is your own enemy. But from tomorrow, I am going to start exposing different enemies that might be the reason why you are not fruitful. Because every seed is expected to be fruitful. Every seed is expected to multiply. Every seed has the capacity to be established and become a tree. So why are you not established? Why are you not fruitful? Why are you not multiplying? There is an enemy you have not discovered. From tomorrow, by this teaching, I will begin to unfold, unveil by the word of God, different kinds of enemies that might be the mystery behind your unproductivity. When you are not living your life to the maximum capacity of God's original intent when you were planted on this earth. Many of you are not fulfilling destiny. You are just managing life. Living in life and fulfilling purpose is two different things. This seed was existing, but the fruitfulness of the seed was under attack by the sons of perdition, the children of wickedness. My God, my God, we are going to lift up prayer. You can still share this video. You can still host it on your page right now. You can still tag somebody. You can still copy it and send it to somebody. The mystery of the seed and the sower. The mystery of the seed and the sower. You are a good seed God has planted on earth to fulfill destiny. Why are you not fulfilling destiny? An enemy attack your destiny. An enemy you have not seen. Invisible enemy. When men slept, you can't sleep. Oh. If you have a destiny, you cannot sleep. If you have potential in you, you have greatness in you, and you know you cannot sleep. Because when you are sleeping, the enemy will take advantage and attack you. Many are sleeping in prayer. Our prayer life is asleep. Our prayer life is asleep. Our steady life is asleep. We are sleeping. We are sleeping. An enemy is holding on to the destiny God has placed inside of you. Can I shock you? If I tell you now that what you are doing, you might be making good money, you might be living in a good house, you might be driving a good car, and yet not fulfilling your destiny and purpose on earth. Yes. Yes. Fulfilling purpose is doing what God ordained for your life. Fulfilling purpose is not to be living a life of survivor, is to be living a life destined by God for your destiny. Yes. Nothing is productive. An enemy has done it. Marriage is not coming forth, and you are a good wife material. An enemy has done it. Whatever you lay your hands upon, never prosper. An enemy has done it. Can't you see yourself? You have great potential. You are so talented. Many of you should be your own boss. You should be a CEO. And you are still looking for a job everywhere. Because that potential to be productive is being under attack. You are existing but not living. An enemy has done it. An enemy has done it. There is great potential embedded in you as a seed when you were born on this earth. But the devil attacked the potential, attacked your greatness, attacked your fruitfulness, and here you are, living like this seed, but not bringing forth fruitfulness and harvest. Oh my shoulder, I want us to pray now. I want us to pray. I'm getting so emotional for the destiny of somebody. I want us to pray. Look at verse number 38 of that scripture. Verse 37. Let's go to verse 37 before we pray now. You are going to pray for yourself. Prayer of deliverance. Before I pray for you, before I join you by faith, you are going to pray wherever you are watching me. You are watching me in your house. I will advise you to get up and walk about. You are driving your car. I would love you to concentrate and fire prayer. You are at your workplace. I would love you to fire prayer wherever you are. If you are privileged to be in the house, you are privileged to be with your children. Gather your children. They are good seed God has given to you. The devil must not be allowed to tamper with their destiny. They are good seed. That child behaving crazy is a good seed. The devil is attacking that child potential. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. That is why you see some families are going through occurrences upon occurrences. From tomorrow, I am going to be unveiling to you, exposing and also discovering, communicating some enemies to you. That might be the reason why the potential in your seed has not maximized. The fruitfulness in your seed has not been productive. The capacity in your seed has not been maximized. The innate ability to enjoy a stable life. Every seed is stabilized. When the seed grows and become a seed and become a tree, that tree is stabilized and bringing forth fruit every year. Every year. Every year. Why is it some year you bring forth fruit, some year you are struggling? Every gift, every tree bring forth fruit after its kind every year. So long, even if that tree is cut down, once it's planted by the rivers of water, it will bring forth fruit again. That is what the Bible said. So when you are a seed that is maximizing potential and you are connected to divinity, even in your struggle, you will prosper. Even in your challenges, you will be productive. Go to verse 37 and 38. Let us pray. Position yourself to pray. Position yourself to fire this prayer. It's a prayer of deliverance. Every attack against your productivity, every attack of wickedness against your ability to be productive on this earth. Let's go to verse 39, verse 37. Somebody project it for me. Project it. Matthew chapter 13, verse 37 and 38. Before we pray, Matthew chapter 13, verse 37 and 38. Somebody help me project it. If you can hear me, please. I'm going to read that scripture, but I need you to help me put it on the broadcast. Help me put it on the broadcast. Matthew chapter 13, verse 37 and verse 38. Help me project it quickly. And he said, and yes, thank you. He answered and said unto them, he that soweth the good seed is the Son of God. He that soweth the good seed is the Son of God. Let me read from another version for you to understand it. He that soweth the good seed is the Son of God. Let's see. Jesus answered, the one that scattered the good seed is the Son of God. The one that sowed the good seed is the Son of God. 38. The field is the world we live in. The field is the world. The seed are the children of the kingdom. The seed are the children of the kingdom. You are a child of the kingdom, planted in this world as a seed to affect your world positively. Last part. But the tares are the children of the wicked. The children of the wicked one, they are the one that did it. I want us to pray. You are going to pray. We are praying. Let us pray with this scripture. Psalm 7 verse 9. The book of Psalm chapter 7 verse 9. We are dealing with every work of wickedness against your productivity, your potential, the original destiny of God for your life. That is a wicked attack assigned to frustrate that agenda for your life. Psalm chapter 7 verse 9. Oh, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end. Let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end. This is one of my favorite scriptures in warfare. One of the scriptures that turned my life around. One of the scriptures that provoked me to discover destiny. Let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end. Hear what he said. Let the just be established. Let the wickedness of the wicked be destroyed, but let the just be established. A just man is a child of the kingdom. A just man cannot be established until wickedness of the wicked come to an end. You cannot enjoy productive life until you destroy the work of wickedness against your life. You cannot enjoy productivity until wickedness against your potential is being destroyed. I want you to pray this prayer. Wherever you are, this is voice of deliverance coming by fire, coming with fire. Lord, every attack of wickedness against my potential and productivity. After this prayer, I'm going to pray for every life. That potential that is lying dormant, that are gifted lying dead in your belly. There are potential in you that you have not discovered. There are greatness in you you have not tapped into. The battles of life have distracted your life and destiny. Before I pray that prayer, and I will call forth every greatness, the anointing for fruitfulness will come upon your destiny. I want you to pray this prayer for yourself. Every attack of wickedness against my ability to be productive, against God's original intent for my destiny, let that attack come to an end. Let every agenda of wickedness, every power of wickedness fighting my fruitfulness, let it come to an end. Let it catch fire in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth, lift up your voice. Wherever you are, begin to fire that prayer. Rakatoba shadabaya. Regadegadu bragadu bragadu zabagaga. Regadebrugadabregadebrugadabregadabrugadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadabregadab gada bregadia, ezuga dini malaganda, ekutu bragaduza, elekoto bazaga deleata. Every attack of wickedness against your fruitfulness, every attack of wickedness against your productivity in the land of the living, my Father, my Maker, I destroy it by fire. I destroy it by fire. Every finger of wickedness, every attack of wickedness against your destiny, against your productivity, against your glory, let it by fire. Let it be destroyed. 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 Lift up prayer. Lift up prayer. Every attack of wickedness against your glory, your productivity, your capacity, your destiny, your prophecy in the land of the living, let that attack of wickedness by fire, by fire, by fire, ragatobaya, regadagado, alekotobayata, elikutubarata, ekurugadabaranta, elebruguduzanda, elekwatabayanta, elegadagada, 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 inanamasunda, elikutuzabaka, elikutuzakatoria, elikwakatunda, elegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegadalegad Bragada, and Namasunda La Bragada, and Danamakasunda, and Lebragadusa Bragada, and Lagada, and Lagada, and Lagada, and Bregadusa, and Namasunta La Bragada, 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 and Lagaragada, Bragada, Bragada, and Tanamalagando Lagadunda, Lengada Bragada Bazanda, and Namasunda, and Brigade, a Brigade, a Brigade, Ragada, Gadagadagadagadagada, and Namachunta La Bragada. Lift up your voice, lift up your voice. Lova Bosunda Bragadia, Regaduza Bragada, Elagado, Elagada, Ebragada, Bragada, 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 and Namasunda La Bragada, and Namasunda La Bragadia, Elagada, 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 Ragada, Gada, 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 Regada, Gada, 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 Ragada, Gada, Rebragado, Sota, Balagada, Lekatuba, Sendalia. Ebragada, 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 Ragada, Gada, 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 Gada. Open your mouth, open your mouth, open your mouth. Every attack of wickedness against your destiny, every attack of wickedness against your life, against your fruitfulness, let it catch fire, let it catch fire, let it catch fire, let it catch fire, let it catch fire. Ragada, Gada, Bragada, 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 Rantana Makatunda, Elagada, Bragada, Endana Makunta, Bragada. Ragadia, ragadagada, 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 elekoto bragada, 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 elagadusa bragato, enamasunta bragadia, regadu le braga, le braga, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Le kabasota balahaza, rekatuba rakatele gada. I pray for that family now. I pray for that sister. Ekabosoto libraga, rekatuma nakasuta baliata, eleketuma negadia, rekatuza balakatoya. Every attack of wickedness, every attack of wickedness, over and against your destiny, by the power of the Holy Ghost, I command that attack to cut fire. I command satanic attack to cut fire. Every finger of wickedness, every attack against your fruitfulness, every attack against your productivity, every attack against your glory and potential, in the name of Jesus, I decree by the power of the Holy Ghost, let that attack by fire now. Let that attack by fire now. Let that attack by fire. Let it by fire. Let it cut fire. Let it cut fire. Lika barata. Holy Spirit, right now you are going to pray. 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 Wherever you are going to pray. And you are going to declare. The Bible said, an enemy has done it. An enemy has done it. Who is the enemy of your life? Who is the enemy fighting your destiny? Who is that enemy that says you will not prosper? Who is that enemy that says you will not get married? Who is that enemy that says you will not be fruitful? Who is that enemy fighting the words of your hands? You are going to cry on top of your voice. You are going to say, my father, in the name of Jesus, every secret enemy, every hidden enemy, fighting my destiny, fighting my fruitfulness, fighting my lifting, in my father's house, in my mother's house, in my neighborhood, around my life, among my friend, every hidden enemy, fighting my harvest, fighting my productivity, by fire, by force, let them be exposed today. Let them catch fire today. Open your mouth and lift up that prayer. Let every hidden enemy be exposed. Be exposed. Be exposed. Rakato bayata. Ela barakata. Ele kutu barata. Ele kutu barata. Ele kutu barata. Ragadagadagadagadagadagada. Ele godagadagada. Ele godagadagada. Ele godagadagada. Ele kutu ragada. Ebragadada. 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 Let them be exposed. 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 We are still praying. Mama, please pray this prayer. Zagada barakata. Lady, please pray this prayer. There are enemies hiding that you will not prosper. The enemy of this man was hiding. He was monitoring the man while he was planting the seed. The enemy was hiding. When he finished planting the seed, the enemy somewhere, somehow, came from nowhere and attacked the potential of the seed. Attack the capacity of the seed. You are too talented to be living like this. You are too gifted to be struggling like this. You carry most potential, yet to show nothing for it. I want you to pray. Every enemy hiding in my life, every enemy hiding around my life, contending with my fruitfulness, let them be exposed by fire. Open your mouth. Let that woman fire prayer. Ila gada 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 gada. Le koto baragato baragato. Ele gado bre ezugada. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Lift up prayer. Le katuba shada. Rekatobaya. 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 Rekatobaya, 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 ragadagadagadagada, regadagada, 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 regadabragadabragada, regadagada, regadaragada, regadaragadabragada. Ah! Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Every enemy. Household enemy. I heard in my spirit to deal with household enemies. Household wickedness. Wickedness generated from your own family. Wickedness that is fighting you from your own family house. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Anyone sponsoring that wickedness in your life, let them be exposed by the fire of God in the name of Jesus. Let every hidden enemy in your family line, that is fighting your greatness, contending with your fruitfulness, sitting on your glory and lifting. Let that enemy be exposed by fire. Let that enemy be exposed by fire. Let that enemy be exposed by fire. Lagada bagada gada gada. Mantoli gada bragadia. Reluga da masunda la brenga dia sunda. Ela gada la gazunga da bragadia. I call for that greatness in you. I call for that potential in you. I call for that prosperity in you. I call for that fruitfulness in you. I call for that greatness, that marital breakthrough, that healing, I call it forth. That breakthrough, I call it forth. That potential, begin to manifest. That greatness, begin to manifest. That potential, begin to manifest. In the name of Jesus, in the life of that woman, in the life of that man, in the life of that lady, I call for that greatness. I call for that potential. That potential, that potential, that gift, I call it forth. That prophetic gift, I call it forth. That potential to prosper, I call it forth. That idea to prosper, that idea for prosperity, that idea for prosperity, I call it forth in your life. Begin to manifest now. I call it forth. I call it forth. That potential for greatness, I call it out of your life. Let it begin to manifest. Let it begin to manifest. That capacity to prosper, that capacity to break through, that capacity for stability, I command in the name of Jesus, in the life of that woman now, in the life of that man now, in the life of that lady now, I call it forth. 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 Begin to manifest now. Begin to manifest now. Begin to manifest now. Yes, 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 yes. Out of your belly, out of your belly shall flow the rivers of living water. Out of that woman shall flow prosperity. Out of that woman shall flow fruitfulness. Out of that woman shall flow expansion. Out of that woman shall flow divine settlement. I prophesy to the life of that woman. I speak to the life of that lady. As many as type amen, I receive it. As many as type in amen, receive that power now. Power, power, power. Power, 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 power to bring forth, power to bring forth, power to bring forth, power to bring forth. Rakotoba shata, rakato barata. I speak to that seed of greatness. I speak to that seed of prosperity. I speak to that seed of marital destiny. Begin to bring forth. Begin to manifest. 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 Begin to manifest in the name of resurrected Christ. Begin to manifest now. Begin to manifest now. Yes, 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 yes. I call for that prosperity in that woman, that lady, that woman that carry the seed of greatness. I command it to germinate and bring forth fruits. That woman with the seed of marital destiny, I call it forth now. That woman with the seed of prosperity, I call it forth now. I call it forth now. I curse that power of struggle. I curse that power of marital disappointment. I curse that enemy of struggle, the enemy of failure, the enemy of disappointment in your life, in your family. I arrest it now. I bind it now. I arrest it now. I bind it now. You will prosper. You will prosper. You will prosper. I prophesy prosperity. I prophesy prophesy prosperity. I prophesy favor. I prophesy greatness. Receive it now by fire.
Rakoto bashada baya. Helego duma legedia. Endolo moshunda lagada bazunda legedia. Rokoto bashedeliata.
I speak into your life. I prophesy now to your spiritual womb. Your spiritual womb. I access it in the realm of the spirit. I command your spiritual womb. Begin to deliver destiny. I prophesy to your spiritual womb of greatness now. Begin to deliver their prosperity. Begin to deliver their greatness now. Begin to deliver it. I call that forth now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Rakoto bashada bayana. Edimolo gozundele grashanda la mayinda. Endunu moshindele gundo brogodia. Maraga de. In the name of Jesus. You are a seed planted on earth, expected to be fruitful. You are a seed planted on earth, expected to prosper. You will prosper. Alika Duba Shada, I feel the unction for prosperity. I feel an anointing for prosperity. It doesn't matter what you have been through. It doesn't matter the battles of your life. It doesn't matter the crisis of your life. Ali Kotoba Shadaba, there's an anointing for prosperity. There is an anointing for fruitfulness. I release that anointing now. 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 The anointing for fruitfulness and prosperity. I heard in my spirit to release that anointing. I heard in my spirit to release that unction for fruitfulness and prosperity. Unction for fruitfulness and prosperity. It doesn't matter where you are in life. It doesn't matter the situation of your life. The situation of this seed never looks like a seed that will bring forth fruits. But this seed encounter an anointing and the seed brought forth a fruitfulness. I decree over that lady. I prophesy over that woman. Connecting on this broadcast, connecting to this anointing, receive that anointing for fruitfulness and prosperity. Receive that oil for fruitfulness and prosperity in the name of Jesus. That anointing is breaking the yoke of financial hardship. That anointing is destroying the yoke of marital disappointments. This anointing is destroying the yoke of struggle over your life. This anointing is destroying the spell of barrenness over your life. Receive that anointing now. Receive that oil now. Receive that oil. I minister to that woman. I minister to that woman connecting by faith. I speak to that woman connecting by faith. I prophesy to that woman connecting by faith. Receive that anointing now. Anointing for fruitfulness. Anointing for prosperity. Anointing for expansion. Anointing for fruitfulness. Anointing for prosperity. Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. You will prosper. You will prosper in your life, in your marriage, in your body. Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now.
Rakotoba shada bayidiata.
The anointing that destroy yoke. The anointing that destroy every demonic chain. The anointing that destroy every attack of wickedness. The anointing that destroy demonic burden. The anointing that terminates struggle. The anointing that lift up burden of marital failure. The anointing that destroy barrenness and unfruitfulness. The anointing that destroy the yoke of marital disappointment. Receive that anointing now. I feel the anointing is generated. The unction is generated via this broadcast. As you are connecting by faith, as you are connecting by typing your yes, as you are connecting by typing your amen, that yoke of delay in your life, that yoke of disappointment in your life, that yoke of marital disappointment, that yoke of financial failure attacking your financial productivity, I command by the anointing, let that yoke be destroyed now. That yoke of sickness, that yoke of infirmity, by the power of the anointing, let that yoke be destroyed now. Let that yoke be destroyed now. Let that yoke be destroyed now.
Rakotoba shadaba lagada. Helegodu mana masunda lagadia. Rekata masoga dene makutuma nagadia. Reketomani gadema nakutumara gadema nakutunza gadia kanda namagunda. Hengudu braganda namunogada zanga da bragadegende naburagenda nagunda bazanda nabangada. Hekutu shagadiata. My Father, my God. Every sick person, many of you, the enemy of your fruitfulness, the Holy Ghost said, is sickness. You heard the testimony of the healing of our sister, the testimony of that sister for healing. On the strength of that testimony, I speak over every life under the attack of sickness. Anyone under the attack of infirmity, in the name of Jesus, I release the healing power of God, the anointing for healing, the unction for healing, the anointing for healing, that attack of the enemy over your earth, the attack of the enemy over your effectiveness, the attack of the enemy in your body, I curse it now. Receive the anointing for healing. 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 Receive healing in your body. Receive healing in your system. Receive healing right now. Let the yoke of sickness be destroyed. Let the yoke of infirmity be destroyed. Let the yoke of disease be destroyed. I command now, let the yoke of satanic infection, let it be broken now. Let it be destroyed now. Diabetes, arthritis, spinal cord pain, stomach pain, let every arthritis, cataract glaucoma, every toothache, every headache, every glaucoma, every migraine, every chest pain, every abdominal pain, every shoulder pain, pain in your neck, every internal disease, heart condition, liver condition, let every attack on your organ, I release healing power. Let the anointing for healing, let it enter you now. Let it enter you now. Let sickness melt, fibroid melts, infirmity melts, disease melts in the name of Jesus. Let the unction for healing, let the anointing for healing, Bible declares, I wish above all things thou mayest prosper
as your soul prospereth, and thou mayest be in good health. As your soul prospereth, I declare good health. I prophesy good health. I declare good health. Receive that anointing for good health. Receive the anointing for good health. Receive the anointing for good health. Receive the unction for good health. Receive the anointing for good health. Receive the anointing for good health. Touch your body now. You are healed. You are made whole. You are healed. You are healed. You are healed. You are healed. Oh, Laba Shadaba. Tap, I am healed to connect. Tap, I am healed by faith. By faith. By faith. Thank God for that healing. Bible declares, when you thank God, you are made whole. You have received your healing. To see your manifestation, type, I receive it. Type, I believe it. Type your amen. Type your amen. The healing of that family, I declare it now. The healing of that family, the deliverance of that family, I prophesy it now. The healing of that family, the healing of that family, I release it. Come on, type, I receive it. Type amen. Type amen. Type amen. Type amen. Type, I am healed. Type, thank you, Jesus. Type, glory to God. Thank God for the healing. Thank God for the healing. Thank God for the healing. I see your healing now. I see your healing now. I see your healing manifesting now. I see the deliverance of that family now. I see the healing of that family now. You are healed. You are healed. Your family is healed. Your children are healed. Your husband healed. Your wife healed. Your body healed. Come on, put your praise on it. Put your praise on it now. Put your praise on it. Put your praise on that healing. Put your praise on that deliverance. Put your praise on that healing. Put your praise on that deliverance. Blessed are those that have not seen but believe. There shall be a performance. There is a performance coming. I should type glory to God. I should type your amen and give God your praise. There is a performance coming. I see performance coming. Performance of that marriage. Performance of that healing. Performance of that restoration. Performance of that lifting. I see it coming. I see it coming. Performance of that fruitfulness. Performance of that expansion. Performance of that promotion. Performance of that lifting. I see it coming in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, we give you praise. Yes, yes, yes. Glory to God. Put your praise on it. Put your praise on it. Put a praise on it now. Put a praise on it now. Put a praise on it. Put a praise. Put your praise on it now. Put your praise on it. Come on, church. Come on, church. Before we praise, before we pray for the nation, put your praise on it. There is a miracle on this line. There is a healing on this line. There is breakthrough on this line. There is miracle on this line. Put a praise on it. 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 I see that miracle. Put a praise on it. Put a praise on it. Put a praise on it. Put your praise. Put your praise. Put your praise on that miracle. Come on, praise him, praise him, praise him. Praise him, praise him. Reka tuma shadamane yate. Holy Spirit. Yes. There's a miracle in this room. There's a breakthrough on this net broadcast. There's a miracle on this broadcast. It's here for you. Come and praise him. Put a praise on it. Put a praise on it. Put a praise on it. Put your praise on it. You gotta put your praise. You gotta put your praise. Put a praise on that miracle. Put a press on that healing. Put a press on it by faith. Put a press on it by faith. Put a press on that deliverance. Put a press on that seed of greatness in you. That seed of greatness. That seed of favor. That seed of stability in you. Come and put it. Put your praise on it. Yes. Rabo Shaba. Put your praise on it. There's a miracle on this broadcast. I feel deliverance, healing, power on this broadcast. Put a press on that miracle. Put a press on it by faith. Put a press on it by faith. Come on, put a press on it. It's coming. It's coming. I see it on your name. I see your name on that miracle. Judy, I see your name on that miracle. Sandra Rochelle, Oliver, she's shouting. I see your name on that miracle. I see your name on that miracle. Shani Reese. I see your name on that miracle, Michelle. I see your name on that miracle, Rochelle Camp. I see your name on that miracle, Vanessa. I see your name on that miracle. I see your name on that breakthrough. I see your name on that healing, on that deliverance. Yeah, yeah. Gonna put a press on. Put a press on it, somebody. Put a press on that miracle. Put a press on that healing now. Put a press on that healing. There's healing. There is healing coming. I'm gonna put a press on it. I'm gonna put the press. Hey. I'm gonna put the press on. I feel power. I'm gonna put the praise on it. Put praise on that miracle. Put praise on that testimony. Put praise on your deliverance. Come on, church. Put praise. Come on, put praise on it. Put praise on that deliverance. Put praise on that healing. The devil is a liar. You can't take my praise. You can attack the seed. You can attack the potential. You can attack the seed. You can attack manifestation. You can attack the seed. You can attack the productivity. Come on, shaman. Come on, shamania. Come on, shout. I dare you to put a price on it. I dare you to put a praise on it. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Lemo Shabahadi. Remane Masundele Gedia. Put that press, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. The devil is a liar. You can attack the seed. You can attack the gifting. You can attack the seed. You can attack the manifestation of fruitfulness. They can attack you as a seed, but they cannot attack your God from bringing you out. They can attack you as a seed, but they cannot attack your gifting. They can take your potential. They cannot kill the dream. They cannot. My. I feel some church in this place. I feel some Holy Ghost church in this place. I feel a movement in my spirit. I feel breakthrough, chains broken in my spirit. I feel what are being stirred up in my spirit. I feel unctions being activated in my spirit. Bow world is broken. The fountains of the deep are broken forth. There's a breakthrough in the spirit for you. There's a breakthrough in the spirit for you. Yes, I am lifted. Be lifted. The devil is a bastard. Be lifted. I miss you too. I miss you too. I miss you too. I'm coming. Don't worry. I'm coming. I'm coming. Whether pandemic like it or not, we are coming. Whether the devil likes it or not, we are taking gospel from city to city, from nation to nation, and from continent to continent. The devil is a bastard. Be lifted. Don't let the devil take your joy. They can attack you as a seed. Don't let them attack your praise. They can attack you as a seed. Don't let them attack your mouth. It can attack you as a seed. Don't let attack your dream. They can attack you as a seed. Don't let them attack your gifting and potential, because if they got my praise together, many will fall at my right hand, 1,000 at my left hand, with my eyes, with your eyes, you shall behold the reward of the wicked. I can't wait for you to come back. I'm coming back. I can't wait for me to see you. I can't wait to see you. I can't wait for us to fellowship together. The devil is a bastard. I feel the Holy Ghost church in this place. I feel the Holy Ghost power. I feel the Holy Ghost church in this place. Holy Spirit of God, thank you, Father. We just put praise on it, and there shall be performance and manifestation in the name of Jesus. Let us pray for our nations right now. In the couple of minutes we have, I want us to pray for our nation. God bless you. Believe God that you are a seed. They can attack you as a seed, but they cannot take away your dream. The innate ability, the potential in the seed could not be taken away, but the enemy attacked the seed. But the devil always misses. The enemy attacked the seed, but God preserve the potential in the seed. The enemy attacked the seed, but God, at the end of the day, preserved the productive ability embedded in the seed. They can attack you. That's what the Bible said. Woe to those that attack the flesh, but they cannot kill their spirits. They can kill the seed. They can attack your body, but they cannot take away your dream. They attack Joseph, but they cannot kill his dream. They sold away Joseph, but they cannot sell his dream. They imprisoned Joseph, but they cannot imprison his dream. And they kill, they destroy, and lie against Joseph as a seed, but they could not destroy the dream that was inside the seed. They might lie against you. They can imprison you. But when your seed is alive, Mamo Shabayata, at the end of the day, the fruitfulness shall manifest in your life.
Glory be to the name of the living Father. God bless you tonight. God bless you tonight. I feel some Holy Ghost church in this place. I feel the Holy Ghost church. Wherever you are, begin to type the name of the nations where you are in. Trinidad, I see Trinidad already. I see St. Vincent already. I see St. Vincent already. Any nation you find yourself, any state you find yourself, any city you find yourself, begin to type it right now as we pray. As we pray, Lukobo, Africa, continent, North Carolina, St. Vincent, we lift up prayer for Trinidad. We lift up prayer for St. Vincent. We lift up prayer for Barbados. We lift up prayer for Barbados. We lift up prayer for Guyana. We lift up prayer for Grenada. Thank you, Jesus. We lift up prayer. We lift up prayer. We lift up prayer for Guyana. 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 We lift up prayer for Ghana. We lift up prayer for New York. Bronx. New York. Queens. New York. Brooklyn. We declare, let the hands of the Lord overshadow New York right now. Let the enemy cease power over the state of New York. I speak over Nigeria. We speak over Europe, over St. Lucia, over Australia. We declare, let the hand of the Lord deliver the land of Cameroon. Let Canada be secure under the power in the name of Jesus. I speak over Venezuela. Let there be a divine release of deliverance by the blood. We declare over bronze. Let bronze be delivered. Let the blood of Jesus travel to Jamaica. Let the blood of Jesus enter the state of Boston. Let the blood enter Chicago. Let the blood enter Queens. We lift up the hand of the Lord over Florida. Let our land be rescued. Let our nations be delivered. Let our city be secure. In the name of Jesus, we curse every power contending with the destiny of Italy. Every force in the high places contending with the nations of our world, we declare Virginia is delivered. Let Japan, let China, let Virginia, let them be secure in the name of Jesus. By the word of the Lord, Switzerland, we declare the hand of the Lord over Switzerland, over St. Kitts, over Venezuela, South Africa. We declare Lesotho, England, Hawaii. Let there be a divine manifestation of God's power. We deploy the blood over Jamaica, Mississippi, over the life and the destiny of people in Amsterdam. We declare, let the blood be deployed to Texas right now in the name of Jesus. We call forth Atlanta in the spirit. Let the hand of the devil over Philadelphia be held back in the name of Jesus. We speak over Haiti right now. Let there be deliverance over the nations of Haiti. Let the hand of the Lord enter Long Island. Let South Africa, Maryland, be rescued from the onslaught of the devil, from the aggression of the devil. Washington, D.C., Bledisburg, Baltimore, Laurel, Maryland, we declare the hand of the Lord to Ethiopia. We deploy the finger of God to Italy, to Egypt, to Ethiopia, to Argentina, to Yugoslavia, to Uganda, to Congo, to Baghdad, to Bangladesh, to Pakistan, to Tunisia, to Algeria, to Libya. Let the hand of the Lord go into COVID, go into Brazil in the name of Jesus. Let there be healing of our land. Let there be healing of our nations. Let there be healing of our land. The healing of our nations in the name of Jesus. Port of Spain, Port of Spain, we declare healing now. We declare deliverance over the continent of our world, over the nations of our world. We declare deliverance of the land. We declare deliverance of the land over Elgon, over Lispier. Let there be healing over Rich Plain in the name of Jesus. We activate the blood. The Bible said, when I see the blood, I will pass over thee. We activate the blood of Jesus in the name of Jesus. By the force of the blood, let the hands of the enemy wither. Let the plague cease. Let the plague cease. The plague of death cease in our land. The plague of death cease in our nation. The plague of death cease in our land. Over the continent of our world, in the name of the Lord Jesus, by the power of the living Father, Puerto Rico
all be delivered in the name of Jesus by the hand of the living Father. Holy Ghost. We declare the blood over the hospitals, over our hospitals, over our police stations, over the fire service. Deliver us, O Lord. Let the hand of the Lord, the angel of death in our hospitals, we arrest you by the hand of the Lord. The angel of death at the hospitals, we arrest you in the name of the Lord Jesus by the power of the Holy Ghost. The Northbrook community, we deploy into Boston. Every hospital in the state of Boston, in the land of Boston, in Columbia, North Carolina, South Carolina, we declare healing in our hospitals, healing at the hospitals, our pharmacies, let them be empowered. Let our hospitals receive healing power of God. The angel of death be arrested by prayer. The angel of death be arrested by prayer. The angel of death in our hospitals be arrested. Holy Ghost. Yeah. Healthcare centers, firefighters, let them be preserved. Our hospitals, we deploy the angel of the Lord to contend with the angel of death at the hospitals. Let life be delivered at the hospitals. Let them be rescued. Angel of death, lose your hold over the hospitals, over the emergency room, over the intensive care. Angel of death, you are under arrest. You are under arrest. You are under arrest in the name of Jesus. Our doctors, let them be preserved. Our doctors, let them be preserved. Our doctors, let them be secured. Let our doctors be covered under the power of the blood of Jesus. Let our nurses, home caregivers, let them be protected in the pool of the blood. Our police force, let them be covered in the blood of Jesus. Our presidents, our leaders, let them be secure in the name of Jesus. By the hand of the Lord, we lift up every hospital in the nations of America, in the nations of our world. Every hospital, let them be covered in the name of Jesus. We declare life to our hospitals. We discharge every infected patient in the realm of the spirit. Let life locate them now. 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 In the hospitals, we declare life at the hospitals, intensive care, home care centers. Let life enter. Let life enter. Let life enter. Let life enter. We declare life. We declare life. We declare life. Thank you, Father. Caretakers, every earth cares. We declare life. We declare life. Anyone infected by this virus, let them be healed. Let them be healed. We declare massive healing this week. We declare healing in the name of Jesus. Our hospitals, let the healing power of God go to the nations of our world. Anyone infected by this virus, let them be healed by the blood of Jesus. Let them receive healing now. 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 In the name of Jesus, we declare healing. We declare healing. We declare healing. We declare healing. Our hospitals. Our hospitals. Let the healing power of God visit our hospitals. Let the healing anointing visit our hospitals. Let the healing balm of Gilead visit our hospitals. Let the blood of Jesus visit our hospitals in the name of Jesus. By the word of the Lord, by the power of the Holy Ghost, because by the stripes of Jesus, the Bible said we are healed. Anyone infected by this virus in the hospitals, let them be healed. 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 Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Father, we give you praise. Father, we give you glory. Father, we give you glory. Every love represented on this broadcast, every life, every family represented on this broadcast, connected to you, wherever they are, your family members, let them be preserved. Every family on this broadcast, every family connected to you, let them be covered. Let them be preserved. I release the blood over every family represented on this broadcast. Every family on this broadcast, I declare your protection. I declare your preservation. I declare your preservation. I declare your protection. You are covered by the blood. You are preserved by the blood. You are covered by the blood. You are preserved by the blood. You are covered by the blood. The Gobbins family, the Wright family, the Reese family, the Williams family, let them be covered. Let them be covered. Let them be covered. In this season, I declare the blood over your family. I release the blood over your children, over your family, your nuclear family, extended family, wherever they are, Alexander family, the Paul family, the Clavy family, the Antoine family, let them be covered. The Carompier family, let them be covered. The Jack family, the Charles family, let them be covered. I lift them up in prayer in the name of Jesus. Every family represented on this broadcast, I cover your family. The Wright family, the Jesse family, I cover them. The Chanting family, I cover them. I cover families. The Francois family, the Francis family, the Sinclair family, the Crow family, you are covered. You are covered. Benjamin family, you are covered. The Lewis family, they are covered. The Reese family, they are covered. I cover them. I cover them. All your children, they are covered. All your family, all your siblings, they are covered. The Lawrence family, the Dunst family, the Chas family, they are covered. The Udos family, the Udos family, they are covered. St. Clair family, they are covered. The Joshua family, they are covered. The Clavy family, the Brown family, they are covered. Yeah. The Lewis family, the Champion family, I declare covering. The covering of the blood, the covering of the blood, the covering of the blood. In this season, no plague will exert on your family. No attack of hell will take you by surprise. In this season, you are exempted. Your family is exempted from satanic plagues. Your house is exempted from demonic aggression. In the name of Jesus, your life is covered. Your life is preserved. Your family is preserved. I immune your body with the blood. I immune your system against every satanic virus. I immune your body against demonic virus. I immune your system against every satanic virus in the name of Jesus. Your family are covered. The Jeffrey, the Jasons, they are covered in the pool of the blood, 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 in the pool of the blood. You are preserved. You are preserved. You are preserved. You are preserved. Thank you, family. Thank you, Jesus. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. Begin to thank God. Begin to exalt the Lord. Begin to magnify him. The Bible said, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Right now, begin to magnify the Lord. Begin to exalt his name. Begin to exalt his name. Begin to magnify the Lord. Magnify the name of Jesus.
The Lord has done great things. 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 Worship the Lord. Worship the Lord. Worship the Lord. Rekobo shabra gadia. Rekadamama sonda nimbrogodinza gadia. Worship the name of your Father. I thank God. I thank God for miracle. I thank God. Yeah. Thank God, Holy Ghost. I give you praise. He has done great things for us. He has done great things for us. He has done great things for you. Begin to thank him. Yes, thank you, Father. Hosanna. Miracles are happening. So much for me. I cannot tell. It still will be enough. Begin to thank God. Father, I worship you. Father, I thank you. I give you praise. I magnify you for what you have done tonight. Thank you, Father. Thank you, God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, we worship you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I thank God for tonight. I worship the name of the Father for what he has done. I cover the word of the Lord in your heart in the blood. I decree in the name of Jesus that which the Lord has done shall be permanent in your life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We give you praise, Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Thank you for joining me tonight. Thank you for being on this broadcast tonight. I thank God for your life, all your comments, all your connecting by faith. By the grace of God, we are fighting a common battle and we shall have a victory. I'm looking forward for your testimony. I'm looking forward for that miracle. I am looking forward to see what the Lord is going to do in your life. You are the next in line for a testimony. You heard the testimony of healing of our sister today. It's a prophetic sign and it's an indication that God is with us, God is with you, and you might be the next in line for a marvelous testimony. You are the next in line for a mind-blowing testimony in Jesus' name. The Lord bless you and keep you. Tomorrow we are continuing the word of God, the voice of deliverance continues tomorrow. The voice of deliverance after the broadcast, you can still share the video. You can still host it as party on your page if you wish. You are free to do it. Be a blessing to somebody by this broadcast. Invite somebody. And I want to take this medium to thank everyone who has subscribed to our YouTube channel. We have subscribed to our YouTube channel, Overcomers TV. Just go on YouTube, type Overcomers TV, scroll down and check it. You will see my picture and you can just subscribe. So any messages that is being uploaded, there you can get an alert and you can listen to them. Like today's message will be uploaded You can go back and listen to it. You can send it to somebody also to listen to it on Overcomers TV, our YouTube channel. The Lord bless you and keep you. I thank you so much, all the men and women of God on this broadcast that took time to watch, listen, comment, like. I thank God. I salute you. I celebrate the grace of God upon your life. God bless you. Tomorrow, we are coming back again. Let's keep praying. Keep trusting God. Don't entertain fear in this season. Feed yourself with God's word and lift up your spirit with the word from God. The Lord bless you. This is Voice of Deliverance. I'll come your way tomorrow. Your life will never be the same again. Thank you. I salute you. Shalom. Bye for now. Bless you.